Hello, what's up? This is Gregory A. Marzek, the Chicago Kid. I'm at the Days Inn Knott's Berry Farm. It's 7121 Beach Boulevard. It used to be a Red Roof Inn, but now they changed it to the Days Inn. So anyway, I come in here today, and the woman, there used to be a manager named Robert, and he was cool, and if there was problems, he would straighten them out. You know, if something was wrong with the room, he'd give me a better deal on a room. But this Jessica couldn't stand me because I'm white. You know, a lot of the people here, they treat you bad when you're white, when you come here, but they'll treat you bad when, no matter what ethnic group you're from, but they're especially prejudiced against white here. I think she's from an Asian descent. But anyways, the truth about it is she tells me I'm not allowed to stay here. I went and bought a bunch of groceries. She told me, oh, you're not allowed to stay here anymore. And then I said, why? And she wouldn't. She finally told me that corporate flunked them during their last test. They tested to see how the rooms were, and she said they mentioned me, and that I'm not allowed to stay here because they didn't like me being here. I have on my jacket that I'm Jennifer Aniston's homeless man, but I'm not a nut. It's a true story. So, and I don't ask people for money. I don't disrespect people. I fix things in the rooms when they're broke. Most of the time, these refrigerators right here, you get them and they thaw out all the time. If you get milk or something, the milk goes bad because it keeps thawing out the whole time. So what I did on a lot of these fridges is I fixed them so that they actually stay ice cold. Well, the whole thing about it is this. She blames me because they flunked their inspection. Well, let me show you something right here. The inspection, if you look down here, you see that rust around there? They were supposed to get new bathtubs. They didn't. They have somebody repaint over them. And when they got these things repainted, and notice this too. See the plug is open? This thing don't even stay on here right, this plug. It's supposed to be connected. They're trying to blame me for this. See along the wall here, there's spray paint. First, for a long time, all these rooms smelled like the spray paint. That's the reason they're flunking here. They're very cheap. They won't fix things they need to be. They're buying more and more properties, but they don't take care of the ones they have now. And let me see what else is wrong here. See this? This is paint on the sink. And let me see, what else did I see here? Look at this microwave. I did not do this to this microwave. See all this shit all over the outside of it? This microwave, this is why they're flunking their inspections. You realize corporate just sent me a thing where I became a member of their cold card thing? I'm homeless, but I'm stuck staying in motels. You see this paint off of here? That's why they're flunking inspections. You see this brown stuff on the wall? You see this other brown stuff on the wall? You see this brown stuff on the wall right here? Shit splattered all over. Nobody cleans it. So they blame me. So they insulted me in front of people that were in the office. And I didn't do nothing wrong here. I've been a very good customer, you know. I, like I said, I don't have a normal place to live. I come here and I stay. I fix things in the room when they're not working. A lot of times there's not maintenance here to do the work. So it's wrong that they disrespect me like this, you know what I mean? So by all means, you should boycott all Days Inn. I'm gonna contact their corporate offices. They're owned by Wyndham Hotels, and hopefully Wyndham does something to straighten this out, because, you know, I've done nothing wrong to anybody. I don't talk crazy. I'll talk with sometimes the desk clerks talk to me, you know, so I talk to them about politics, about this Jennifer Aniston stuff, but it's all real. I'm not a nut. So I did nothing wrong, but this Jessica can't stand me. The one thing she complained about is if I check out late, but sometimes I don't get in here till 11 o'clock at night. So if it's 11 o'clock at night and check-in was at 3, you figure 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. That's 8 hours that I'm missing here. Should she give me the money off when I check in late? You know what I'm saying? Should be 24 hours at least. I get a lot of times I don't get to, you know, 24 hours. Another thing is they don't allow weekly rates out here in California, and after 28 days you have to check out.
Well, in Chicago, in Illinois, I don't know if it's the same, but they made it a law. If you stay there a week, you automatically get a weekly rate. And after 30 days, you get all the tax money back for every day you stay there. Here they got it set up so they can rip you off. And you become an unstable, you have to pay daily instead of weekly. And even when they got a weekly, they don't want to refund the tax money. They try to rip everybody off for every dime. It should be made into a federal law that you get a weekly rate after a certain amount of time. I don't know. It's very unfair with the motels out here. They figure people are stuck staying here because you got your Disneyland and Knott's Berry Farm. I'm telling you, as prejudiced as people are against white people here, I would never come here. Because, you know, I like all different kinds of people, and there are some real good people from the Mexican descent, and some nice blacks, and some nice Orientals. But these Orientals have ripped me off for a lot of money, man. When I stayed in Hollywood over there, they ripped me off for a lot of money. So boycott Days Inn, and thank you very much, and y'all have a nice night. Bye-bye.